What's up, Toast? CamHorda11 here, and today I'm playing Pony Space, which is like a Dead Space parody game, and it's really simplistic, and I enjoy it a lot, because the graphics are really nice, and looks like it was made in Flash or something. You can also change the quality depending on your computer, so whether it can run better or not, but it should be able to run the highest quality. It's a really small game, and it's made by MixerMike622, so hats off to him. As always, throw a link into the description if it's an online game. You can check it out yourself, play it, and give your thanks to him for making a good game. So, we're going to play with survival mode because that's the only game mode available. And let me just look over these controls because I haven't actually played it in a few weeks. So, we got A, we got D, we got W, space, click to shoot, A mouse. Okay. I think I'll be good. Let's do this. Oh god. I always feel like I need to jump, but oh god, oh god. This is scary. I like the game. I like games like this because it messes with what My Little Pony is at the core. At the core, you know, it's a show that was for like little girls, and I say was because it's not anymore. Now it's for like bronies and shit, but I like how they mix the original formula with something like scary, like Dead Space. And if there's gonna be a story mode to this game, like if the creator goes through with it and makes a full length, oh god, you gotta use the rockets. If the creator goes through with it and like makes a full length game, I think that would be totally awesome, and I would support it 100%. And obviously, there's some really big projects in the works. There's this My Little Pony fighting game, which I'll be all over when that comes out. Oh, there's a racing game that's like got Mario Kart elements. Evident Mario Kart. You can tell by the levels, level design. You tell like the kart, the characters and stuff. There's a lot of like Mario Kart inspiration elements in there. I think it's just like they take stuff from your, not from your childhood, but they take memories that you're really fond of, like Mario Kart and even Dead Space. I mean, I'm not a personal fan of Dead Space, but some people may really like Dead Space, and when they give it that, oh god, ah, when they give it that pony element, I think it makes it more fun and lighthearted. Like, normally I wouldn't play any, like, Dead Space related game, because Dead Space is just isn't my taste. But, you know, when they give it that pony, oh god damn it, that pony coloring, or coating, it's really neat. Ah, damn it. I think this might be the best I've ever done. Shit, okay, I keep forgetting to use the space bar. Because I believe that's something good. Oh god. I guess I got one hit left. Ah. Must resist. Ah. That's what space does. And I always use the up button at the worst time. So I do recommend you give this game a try, because it's really, you know, it's simple. It's just like one of those endless type deal. It looks like it's wave-based. It tells you, tells you how much you've survived. And there's that cutscene at the end. Nothing too bad, but let's see. Survived 219 score. Let's give it one more try. Hit up the main menu. And this extras menu, it's not really an extras menu now. It's just what he's saying is the stuff that he's done to the game, or what he plans on doing, or what he has done. I'm not sure exactly what's... Oh, this page would be a temporary place for notes or little things, basically a page for whatever. So, it's a really nice game, and we're just going to hit up the survival again, see if we can do better, use that space bar item more, maybe when it crowds up the screen. Looks like all it does is freeze, though, so I don't find that very helpful. I'd rather have these guys off the screen as fast as possible. I'd love to see a story mode. I bet it'd be like side-scrolling type. Where, oh god, you have to go through the world and, like, they'd come from behind or in front like this. And I'd love to see if there's any story elements that are thrown in, because these look like Rainbow Dashes and Twilights, zombified versions of them. And this is probably the worst I've seen the ponies in, like, when people do, like, remakes and stuff. I think this is the goriest ones I've seen. I mean, I'm sure there's worse. Worse, if you're a brony, you know about cupcakes, that's pretty bad. And, I think this comes pretty close. I'm doing pretty good. Almost a minute in. Almost a minute. Come on, I could do it. For now, oh god, damn it, I shouldn't have gotten hit there. For now, it's not really, like, scary, in, like, for lack of a better word, because it's really, you know what's coming, they just run up to you, and, you know, and you have to kill them. There's not really, and it makes the same sound effect, so it's not, like, a suspense drama, like, you're not scared, because you know what to expect. But I think with the story mode, it'll be really, like, suspenseful, it'll be quiet, it'll go from quiet, okay, let's try and status, oh god. I don't know why it's called a status. I don't know if there's a double meaning to that. And I think I just noticed, even on your character, the thing changes, so that's really nice attention to detail. Like I said, this is probably one of the best graphically. I think this is one of the best games I've seen developed for the ponies. Or, like, that is in a somewhat playable state. Because, like, I've seen, like, screenshots and stuff of games that are in the works. Oh, come on, that didn't even touch me. Oh, God, come on. I see. Oh, God, there was no way. Oh my god. Like, I've seen screenshots of games that are in the works that have really nice graphics, but I mean, they're not out yet for the general public to play, so let's give it one more try. I'm just having too much fun. And I'd like to see other ponies. It looks, I don't know if Pinkie Pie is going to be a constant as the main protagonist, but I think that'd be cool. Because Pinkie Pie is always usually laughy and stuff. Happy smiles all around. It'd be nice to see a darker game, but I don't think I finished what I was talking about before, the story. Like, to see a story with a game like this, because I think Dead Space is really, like, heavy on a story. I can't say, because I'm, like, terrified off my balls to play Dead Space, but, you know, who knows? I've been getting more open with, like, the games I play. Sort of. It's usually, like, a budget basis type thing. Like, I don't have the money, but I mean, like, I could probably rent a Dead Space for a few days and pop it in, play it a little bit, and maybe record something if you guys want to see. So tell me, I guess, if you want to see Dead Space, because I genuinely want to play more games, but there's so many games out there, and so many of them are first person shooters. It's I don't know what to play, what's the best. I generally just go off sales. So like, Call of Duty dominates the sales, so I'm gonna play Call of Duty. And personally, I'll tell you, I have played Battlefield, so I'm like, it's okay, but I mean, for me, it's no COD killer. I like Call of Duty more, and I mean, don't hate, because I mean, that's generally just my opinion. I mean, hate if you want, but it's not going to do anything. It's not going to change anything. I may play Battlefield. I just, getting my hands on a copy, that's the main issue. So, yeah. Dead Space, I'm really interested now that I think of it, because, I don't know, I've seen gameplay footage, and usually, but it's been a while since I've actually seen gameplay footage, so, I don't know if Dead Space is due, oh god, they're getting faster, I don't know if Dead Space is due for a sequel, damn it, get your hands off me, a rapid fire, get your hands off me, Twilight, oh, come on, not cool, yeah, these Twilights are pretty scary, because they actually have their, oh, come on, what the, bullshit, oh my god, and the thing that makes this one hard is they don't give you, like, usually when you get hit in a game, you, like, you go a little blinky, and, 2-2, I don't remember what my first time was, you go, like, blinky, and then you have some time, you're invincible for, like, 2 seconds, but in this game, they just bombard you, and I'm sure that's what a real survival horror game should be like, but, god damn, so, hats off to Mixer Mike again for making this game. It's really fun at the moment. I can't wait to see what goes on with the rest of it, and certainly I'll be playing it when the full version comes out. So I hope you guys enjoyed. Like I said again, I'll throw a link in the description so you guys can play it yourself. And bye.